The region of Mopti in the center of Mali is an area plagued by intercommunal violence, mainly between two rival communities, Dogons, who are traditionally sedentary farmers, and the Fulani, more nomadic cattle breeders and traders. The local ecosystem and competition for access to land and natural resources made these communities both dependent on each other and rivals for decades. Despite frequent tensions, the two communities managed to coexist. But at the beginning of 2010, jihadist groups appeared in this part of the Sahel, and the situation became considerably more complicated. Tensions increased, and the state had been helpless and failing.
The state has not asserted authority over the land. So the current situation is that we have many self-proclaimed leaders declaring it theirs. This has led to an erosion of authority of the state.
It is in this context that more and more deadly attacks have taken place, like the one on March 23rd of this year, the massacre of Ogasagu, where more than 160 people died.
They destroyed these vehicles. They destroyed people's homes. The damage is immense. They ransacked our mothers' homes. They made sure they left nothing behind. For the rest, we look to God.
This was the bloodiest killing in the country since the French military's Operation Serval launched in 2013. The goal was to oust jihadist groups from northern Mali. But faced with the threat of jihadists, armed self-defense groups and militias are developing. An outbreak of violence against civilians, the Malian army hasn't managed to stop.